गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक अगेन इन ऑनलाइन क्लास। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद न्यू यूनिट ऑफ द सेकेंड चैप्टर फिजिकल क्वालिटीज एंड मेजरमेंट। ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द व्हाट आर द फिजिकल क्वालिटीज एंड हाउ वी कैन मेजर दैट। ओके, इन यूनिट फर्स्ट क्लियर। Now, today we will start the second unit, measurement of mass and time. So first, before discussing the measurement of mass, means how we can measure the mass and time, these two are what basic fundamental qualities. So first we know that what is the mass and what is the time. In first chapter, already we have discussed about, means we can find the mass of a given substance, means matter. Every substance or a matter having some mass. So we always find the mass of a given substance, means matter only. Here, if it is non-matter, we can't find the mass. Suppose I am telling you, find the mass of your emotions. You can find? No. Because we can't measure the emotions. It is not a physical quality. It does not have any physical existence. Okay? Suppose I am telling, just find the mass of your vice, your wand. Okay, so we can determine the mass of only matter, physical substance or physical qualities, that is the matter. Maybe it will be solid, liquid or gas. Three types of matter are there. So in case of solid, the matter is made up of the molecules. And inside the matter, means in solid, the molecules are very tightly packed, bound with each other, with an intermolecular force. Intermolecular force, every matter, like this, okay? Marker, na? This is also a solid, plastic, solid. Na? So here it is made up of different small particles, element, okay? Atoms, molecules. Here, the smallest unit of this particular solid is called what? Atom. Then group of atoms form molecules here, and group of molecules form compounds, and the compounds is also called a matter or a substance. Clear? So first we know that what is the mass that is, okay, contained by a substance or a matter. So basically mass, the whole quantity contained in a particular substance or a object is called mass. Means whole quantity is whole quality, complete quantity of the matter. Just like this, in case of this marker, just I am doing that, find the mass of this, means how much quantity it contains. So we have to find its mass. This mass will determine its complete amount, quantity, the total amount of object contained in it. That is called its mass. Clear? Now, we will talk how we can measure it. So by using different instruments, devices as we need, according to this we will measure the mass of a given quantity. Depend upon the matter, substance, if it is solid, we can measure it through the physical balance. Okay, it is a device, physical balance, it is given to see open page number 29. This is the physical balance, first one. Beam balance or Grosser balance, that is used by the grocery shop. Okay, all of you just have seen now at the grocery shop. The particular shopkeeper used the Grosser balance to measure the particular mass or weight of given object. Okay, electronic balance also, just we are now using, different shopkeeper used electronic balance. Clear? And also one more thing is given, compression balance. Compression balance. So these instruments or devices, means these type of balancing devices used to measure the mass of given solid. Okay, either you can say that liquid, but if it is contained in a particular vessel or container. In other way, we can measure the liquid, is also type of matter. So how we can measure the mass of a liquid? So we can measure the mass of a liquid in different units. Okay, for that we use the different type of measuring devices. Liter. We can measure the liquid in liter, 1 liter, 2 liter, 3 liter. But in case of solid, we can measure the mass of a given substance in kilogram. It means kilogram is the standard unit, the standard international unit, SI unit of the measuring mass. What? Kilogram. So by using different physical balance, means balancing devices, physical balance, okay, beam balance, means that is grocery balance, electronic balance, compression balance, we can determine the mass of given object. Okay, clear? And unit SI means kilogram. Also there are some multiples and some multiples units is given. Kilogram is basic. So we can understand this sum multiple and multiple units of this given SI unit kilogram. 1 kilogram is also equal to 1000 gram. Okay? And 100 kilogram is equal to what? 1 quintal. Means for any heavy object, we will use the quintal. Okay, if object or this particular substance is very heavy. Okay, for lighter body, you can use the gram, either milligram. Again, more heaviest, so 1000 kilogram, 1 metric ton. Clear? For big stone, very big stones, okay? Clear? That is, we use the metric ton or quintals. This is the multiple units of the SI unit, kilogram. Some multiples means for the lighter bodies, we use what? Gram. Clear? 1 kilogram, 1000 gram, either 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram and 1 gram is equal to what? Milligram. So 1000 milligram. So according to our requirement, our need, we will use the these type of multiples and submultiples units. This object is very lighter, very small body, so we can measure, we can use to find the, or we can measure the mass of the given object, if very lighter, very small, in gram or milligram, either standard in kilogram, and if it is heavier object, okay, heavier objects, according to that, quintal or metric ton. Okay, students, clear? Here some key points is given, that is what for the measuring mass of the object, just we are using a particular device, means kilogram, that we call this one. For studying the mass of heavier bodies, a bigger unit is used, it is called quintal. Okay, and we using the weight box. All of you have seen at the grocery shop or at the retail shop, no? That particular person or software use the weight box in the shape of hexagonal shape, like you see weight box, 1 kilogram, 2 kilogram, okay, 5 kilogram, 200 gram, 500 grams. So that person, means that particular shopkeeper, use a weight box or weighing box to measure the mass of the given solid or liquid object or any type of substance. According to the requirement, he or she will use the multiple or submultiple units. Okay? Clear? So how we can measure? What is the need of the measurement of mass? Suppose just you go to the vegetable shop or fruit shop and want to purchase some fruits. So how can you ask the shopkeeper? Give this, okay? How can you ask for the shopkeeper? Just you ask, now, bhaiya, give me some fruits. But in which quantity or in which particular rules, units, that shopkeeper will give you that particular fruits. So for that, we need, okay, what? Measurement and units. Now how we can measure the given particular matter? So kilogram, okay, either gram, milligram, quintal or metric ton. This is the requirement of the this particular fundamental units and their measurement. Okay, students, next one, measurement of time. Time, you know, what is the time? How can I define time? Successive interval gaps between the two events. इंटरवल गैप्स बिटवीन द टू सक्सेसिव इवेंट्स, दो घटनाओं के बीच का जो अंतराल होता है, क्लियर, दैट इज कॉल्ड द टाइम. सपोज आई एम स्टैंडिंग हियर, जस्ट आई एम टीचिंग यू, आफ्टर सम टाइम श्योर आई विल गो फ्रॉम हियर टू आवर होम. ओके, सो द इंटरवल गैप बिटवीन द टू इवेंट्स दैट वी कैन डिटरमाइन और व्हाट सेड द Clear? So in detail we will discuss about the time. Okay, how we can measure time, which type of devices that we used in present time and also that we used in ancient time. Okay, what is the particular SI unit and units we use to measure the time, we will discuss in the next class. Okay, so go through this video and try to understand all the points regarding the mass, measurement of mass and its unit. Distance. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Measurement of weight. I have an apple in one hand and an orange in another. Can you tell me which is lighter?
Oh, Neha, these fruits are in your hand. You can feel their weights. How can I know that which is lighter? But I can tell you how to get the correct answer. To know whether an object is heavier or lighter than the other, we use a beam balance. It has two pans. When nothing is put on the pans, these remain in the same level. Let us put the apple on one pan and orange on the other pan. We see now that the pan containing the apple goes down and the other pan goes up. This means the apple is heavier than the orange. The pan containing heavier objects goes down.
What happens when after putting objects on the pans, these remain on the same level?
Obviously, this means the objects have equal weights. Observe the balance now. Let us measure the weight of this cup using marbles. Put the cup on any of the pans. Now on the other pan, put some marbles. The pans are still not in the same level. Put some more marbles till the pans come in the same level. We see that there are 10 marbles in the pan. So weight of the cup is 10 marbles.
Do we have any standard unit of measuring weight?
Of course, Neha. We use grams and kilograms to measure things. Light objects are weighed in grams and heavier objects are weighed in kilograms. There are 1000 grams in 1 kilogram.